অনেকে আমাকে প্রশ্ন করছেন যে কংগ্রেস সভাপতির পদ ত্যাগ করবার পর আমি কি করব। এর উত্তরে আমি সর্বপ্রথমে আপনাদের স্মরণ করিয়ে দেব যে আজ ভারতবর্ষের সম্মুখে একটা মস্ত বড় সুযোগ উপস্থিত হয়েছে। এই সুযোগ যদি আমরা গ্রহণ করতে পারি, যদি ঠিক পথে চলে কৌশল অবলম্বন করে,
লেট আস টেক ফুল অ্যাডভান্টেজ অফ দ্য প্রেজেন্ট ইন্টারন্যাশনাল সিচুয়েশন অ্যান্ড অ্যাচিভ আওয়ার গোল অফ কমপ্লিট ইন্ডিপেন্ডেন্স।
পূর্ণ স্বরাজ লাভ করা আমাদের পক্ষে মোটেই কঠিন হবে না।
But in 1940, he was languishing in prison. So he gave an ultimatum to the British government and undertook a fast unto death. The government yielded and released him temporarily, ensuring, of course, that his activities and his movements were closely watched. On the 17th January 1941, at 1:35 a.m., Netaji, in the guise of an upcountry Muslim, Muhammad Ziauddin, tiptoed out of his room, went across the length of his Elgin Road house, and came down the rear staircase where I had parked the car. We drove out of the house in a most natural fashion and took the Grand Trunk Road. On the night of 18th January, we reached Gomo station, where he boarded the Delhi-Kalka mail on his way to Peshawar.
Subhash Chandra Bose was born in Cuttack on January the 23rd, 1897. He was the ninth child of Janakinath and Prabhavati Bose. Brilliant in his studies, Subhash Bose eventually proceeded to England and successfully competed for the Indian Civil Service in 1920. Subhash Chandra Bose, Esquire, ICS. No, it sounded too much of a parody of his values. To him, life had but one meaning and one purpose, to seek freedom from bondage of every kind. Vande Mataram solved the dilemma he faced. Returning to India in 1921, Subhash Bose prepared himself for his baptism of fire in the independence struggle. Under the guidance of his guru, Deshbandhu Chittaranjan Das, he organized a total boycott in Calcutta on the occasion of the visit of the Prince of Wales to India. This resulted in the first of his many journeys to jail under British rule. In 1924, when C.R. Das was elected Mayor of Calcutta, Subhash Bose was appointed Chief Executive Officer. 6 years later, even while in prison, he was elected the Mayor of Calcutta. 1921 to 1938, one agitation after another, in and out of jail, periods of exile. A brave man reduced to utter physical exhaustion. Subhash Bose was released on the express condition that he sought treatment outside India. In Europe, he missed no opportunity to campaign for the cause of India's independence. In January 1938, while abroad, he was elected President of the Indian National Congress. An extremist, in his own words, with the firm principle, all or none, Subhash Bose was indeed the most controversial political figure of his time. At the Tripuri session in 1939, he was elected Congress president for the second time, defeating Gandhiji's chosen nominee, Pattabhi Sitaramaiah. Subhash Bose, at that time, was for direct action against the British government.
Friends,
outside India, the international situation appears to be favorable to India and her cause. And I believe that this is an opportunity which we cannot afford to lose, which India will not lose.
But this was not accepted by Gandhiji and others. Eventually, he was forced to resign from the Congress presidentship and formed the Forward Bloc. In 1939, Subhash Bose invited Rabindranath Tagore to lay the foundation stone of the Mahajati Sadan in Calcutta, a memorial hall to the freedom fighters.
Jar sanskar mukta udar atithe manushyatter sarbangin mukti akritrim satyata labh kare.
After his disappearance from Calcutta to Kabul, Subhash Bose arrived in Berlin. At a meeting of the Free India Center,
we are now living in a period which is pregnant with immense possibilities. This is an opportunity which is rare in the history of a nation, which we cannot afford to lose, which India will not lose. Every commodity in this world has its price. So also has freedom. I appeal to you to be ready to pay the price of freedom, which is service and suffering.
The first Azad Hind Forge was formed in Berlin in September 1941, comprising Indian prisoners of war from Europe and North Africa.
Azad Hind Forj apne matrabhumi ki aur kooz kar rahi hai.
In December, Japan attacked Pearl Harbor and the Second World War spread to Asia. The fall of Singapore rocked the foundations of the British Empire. Meanwhile, in India, the Indo-British parleys based on the Cripps Mission made little headway. Finally, Mahatma Gandhi gave the Quit India call. The Indian freedom struggle was nearing the final phase. In June 1942, at a meeting in Bangkok, the Indian community invited Netaji to assume the leadership of the Indian freedom movement in East Asia. In response to the invitation, Netaji made a perilous journey in a German submarine around the Cape of Good Hope toward Penang. It took him 90 days, a change of submarines from the German to a Japanese, and a final trip by plane to reach Tokyo.
India and Japan have in the past been bound by deep cultural ties which are about 20 centuries old. In recent times, these cultural relations have been interrupted because of the British domination of India. It is, however, certain that when India is free, these relations will be revived and will be destiny.
Early in July 1943, Netaji arrived in Singapore. Veteran revolutionary Rash Bihari Bose, founder of the Indian Independence League, who had made Japan his home to save himself from British reprisal, entrusted Netaji with the leadership of the League.
Salam to Palam, Malaya Jashri Salam. Friends and comrades in arms, you might ask me what I did in Tokyo for, cause what present I have brought for you. Well, I have brought for you this present. Subhash Chandra Bose is a brilliant leader and an uncompromising fighter. Friends and comrades in arms, in your presence today, I resign my office and appoint this Subhash Chandra Bose as President of the Indian Independence League.
Shri Raj Bihari Ji Bose, पूर्वी एशिया की जंगे आजादी की नुमाइंदो बहनों और भाइयों, सबसे पहले मैं आप लोगों के दिली इस्तकबाल के लिए और साथ ही साथ आपने जो मुझको पूर्वी एशिया की जंगे आजादी के नेता बनाया, इसके लिए भी तहे दिल से आप लोगों का शुक्रिया अदा करता हूं।
On October 21st, 1943, Netaji established the Provisional Government of Azad Hind in Singapore. Chalo Dilli was a thundering war cry that the men of the Indian National Army heard from their supreme commander. There were no promises made, there were only promises to keep. Give me your blood, I will give you freedom. This is the demand of Liberty Brigade.
The Rani of Jhansi Brigade was formed by Netaji with the idea of giving Indian women also a chance to take part in the fighting movement. 75% of the members of the Rani of Jhansi Regiment were purely trained as infantry soldiers and officers.
Netaji, while organizing the Indian National Army, also set about gaining recognition for the Azad Hind government from friendly nations. First week of November 1943, Netaji attended the Greater East Asia Conference held in Tokyo.
So long as Anglo-American imperialism is not overthrown, India has no hope of achieving her liberty. We are therefore determined to fight shoulder to shoulder with you, no matter how long and hard the struggle may be, and no matter what the suffering and the sacrifice involved may prove to be.
Your names will go down in history, not merely as the makers of a new Nippon, not merely as the makers of a new East Asia, not merely as the makers of a new Asia, but as the makers and the architects of a new world.
On December 29th, Netaji arrived at Port Blair to take control of Andaman and Nicobar Islands. Japan had earlier announced the handing over of these territories to the Azad Hind government. The liberation of the Andamans was likened by Netaji to the liberation of the Bastille during the French Revolution. He renamed the Andamans as Shahid and Nicobar as Swaraj. With the war guns booming across the eastern borders of India, the advance headquarters of the INA were shifted to Rangoon.
The INA formations which took part in the Battle of Imphal were number 1 division under the command of General Mohammad Zaman Kiani. It had 3 brigades. Number 1 brigade, known as the Subhash Brigade, was commanded by me. Number 2 brigade, known as Gandhi Brigade, was commanded by Inayat Kiani. Number 3 brigade, known as Azad Brigade, was commanded by Colonel Gulzar Singh. In addition to this, there was the intelligence group which was under the command of Colonel Shaukat Malik.
We are conscious that the soil of India is going to be the last theater of war in this part of the world. Friends, I do not know how many of us who are going to participate in the coming battles will survive to see India free. But whether we survive or not, whether we individually live to see India free or not, we are confident that India shall be free. We are confident that Anglo-American imperialism will be wiped out of India. We are confident that the menace that now hangs over East Asia will be removed once for all.
कदम कदम बढ़ाए जा, खुशी के गीत गाए जा, ये जिंदगी है कौम की, तो कौम पे लुटाए जा। कदम कदम बढ़ाए जा, खुशी के गीत गाए जा, ये जिंदगी है कौम की, तो कौम पे लुटाए जा। तू शेर हिंद आगे बढ़, मरने से फिर भी तू न डर, उड़ा के दुश्मनों का सर, जो शेर वतन बढ़ाए जा। तू शेर हिंद आगे बढ़, मरने से फिर भी तू न डर, उड़ा के दुश्मन का सर, जो शेवतन बढ़ाए जा। कदम कदम बढ़ाए जा, खुशी के गीत गाए जा, ऐ जिंदगी है कौम की, तो कौम पे लुटाए जा। कदम कदम बढ़ाए जा, खुशी के गीत गाए जा, ऐ जिंदगी है कौम की, तो कौम पे लुटाए जा।
The unpredictable monsoon cut off even the slender lines of supplies and halted the march towards Delhi. To add to the distress, the INA had no air cover. On the other hand, the Allied forces commanded unlimited air support and continuous reinforcements.
Know how many of us who are going to participate in the coming battles will survive to see India free. But whether we survive or not, whether we individually live to see India free or not, we are confident that India shall be free.